What will be your story now? Today it's something far inside. Hurt your body, close your eyes, and I'll bring you back to here. You are my own sinking ship. Every day the current shifts, and I picked apart your wasted life to get you back to here. Oh, it's the last time we'll fall in love. Oh, it's the last try to break apart.
Wow, I've just become immensely relaxed.
Relaxed,
which
chilled.
Is probably the worst thing that can happen when you're in the middle of a show, but I am very relaxed anyway.
But we decided that our new thing is 30 minutes to 11 o'clock. We're going to now
a wind down, if
have
you will.
A wind down, because people like to just chill out. People are in bed. Dee, my friend, is in bed listening on her laptop.
Yeah, I think it's kind of weird when people are listening to you in bed that you're in their head when
I know.
In bed.
This is the last thing.
We could kind of do like, we could get Paul McKenna in. Sleep.
Dear,
when you awake, you will be a chicken.
Mike, hello, Mike. Let's call our boyfriend.
All right, I thought you said hello to the microphone. I was like, what's
no,
she doing?
Call our boyfriend, Mike. But Deirdre was actually in Electric Picnic, Tony.
Wow.
Yeah, she was playing the cello.
Oh, she was actually playing?
Yeah, she was playing in one of the tents. Isn't that brilliant?
Awesome.
So I actually know someone who played in the
electric. I was probably there in the tent.
Yeah, you've probably seen her.
Being a ridiculous
person. She's
really
cool looking. She's like a blonde, kind of surfy kind of hair. Real cool.
Blonde, surfy kind of hair.
Yeah, she's that kind of surfy look about
surfer
her. So we're in work today and she is still wearing her flip-flops and her jeans and her wee hoodies. She's determined to not let it. Yeah, she's determined not to let it be winter.
That's
and
amazing.
I'm in my woolen jumper and my big boots, so the two of us
dying
are trying to fight.
It to be winter.
I can't wait for it to be winter, and she doesn't want it to be winter.
That's amazing.
It's like us
I
two.
Like that.
Yeah, yeah. So she's holding on to the last bit of sunshine. So she's a first time listener, and she also has a show on False FM, which is our rival.
Almost a sister station,
yeah, but
if you will.
Yeah, but it's the Gilgore
almost a rival.
One, so
it's halfway there.
Yeah, so if she lets us know when she's on, maybe people can tune in.
We also have Robbie McMillan.
Yes,
he's a first time listener as
yes,
well.
Yes, hi Robbie.
He's looking some cranberries at Dolores O'Rourke.
Do you know what? I would love a bit of cranberries.
I'm actually searching for it right now.
Yeah, I like that. And also the last song was Good Old Sinking Ship.
That's amazing. How do you do that? You have it wrote in front of you. It was Good Old War.
Don't you
and the song
have it
is
written
called
in front of
My
you?
Own Sinking Ship.
Same thing.
The Good Old Warship. Oh my
Just
God.
Like my granddad used to tell me. Oh,
see right. The story we're about to talk
yeah.
about? Yeah.
Mm.
The answer for the question, do you should be radio presenter? Sorry, listeners, that was a private joke. But
yeah,
anyway.
Was. Right, I've got a story in and Seamus has sent this in. He says, sting in the tail for a pest controller. A pest controller has vowed to carry on his job despite discovering he is allergic to wasps and that one sting could kill him. He says that he's got an EpiPen now in his pocket and he will use it if he's stung, but he doesn't want to give up his job.
God.
So the question, Tony, to you is, would you give up your dream job if you find out you couldn't speak or if you couldn't, I don't know, what would you do?
Would I give it up? Well,
yeah.
if I couldn't speak, I don't think I'd have much of a choice. But
you could just press the buttons.
If it was a high threat of death,
yeah.
I suppose it's kind of, I don't know, would you? It depends on the circumstance.
Yeah.
What job do you think you would be really, really bad at? Like, you know the way he is an exterminator, a bee exterminator,
yeah,
and
yeah.
if a bee sting is going to kill him,
yeah.
that's pretty much... You're bad at your job,
yeah.
you know? What job do you think you'd be horrible at?
Probably a driving instructor.
Yeah.
Here, I haven't ranted this week. I've been very good. I've got no car parking fines. Still haven't paid last week. I have till Friday to do it. But I drove over a police cone. So I was
oh
a wee bit
God.
Of a rebel this week.
Did you do it on purpose?
No, I didn't know.
It's like
there.
A two-finger salute to the state.
No, I was in the car park and I drove forwards, not knowing there was a cone in front of my car. And then I was like, what? Oh, no, my clutch is went again. So then I looked to
I'm
the right.
I'm not surprised.
And
your
there was
clutch
two.
Goes.
No, it hadn't went. I thought that's what happened. And there was two value cab taxi drivers looking at me, pointing to the car. And then I got out and I was like, did I just drive over a cone? And then they were like, yeah. So I had to get on my hands and knees, try and pull it out. So got it out, then got back into the car. And then they were pointing again to me. And I was like, oh no, if I drove over another cone. So I got back out. They were like, your cardigan's hanging out of the car. And I was like, right, get me out of here.
Embarrassing.
So there we go. What about you? What would you think you'd be bad at?
I'd probably be bad as a pilot.
Why would
I have
that
ridiculously
be?
Bad eyesight.
Serious?
Yeah. Like really bad eyesight.
So have I actually.
I almost
think...
can't read that poster on the wall, which for the listeners is
okay.
about 5 meters away.
You're blind.
Yeah.
Also, right, Facebook pages, right? There's loads of these pages that have been set up and, you know, for different things. You know, you just have to smile and someone can set up a Facebook page about you. And there's a bearded man, apparently, Tony, who sits on the side of a road between two seaside resorts waving at every car, and he's now become a Facebook hit, right? The man who calls himself Moses Peter, as you do,
Peter?
Yeah, awesome. Has spent years sitting on a bench between Torquay and Paidston, I think it is, in Devon. I probably said that wrong. But every day he sits there with his headband and sits on the A3022 waving at passengers for hours. And now they've set up a Facebook site called Strange Old Man who sits
That's
on
amazing.
A bench on the road between Torquay and Paidston. Do you reckon if me and you sat on the roundabout there in the Falls Road
for long enough
and waved to people, someone would set up a Facebook
I
page
I think we'd
us?
Pretty much just be moved on. I don't think we'd last too long.
I've seen a Facebook status today. It was that you know you have a friend when you can phone them up at 3 a.m. and they can help you bury a dead body. It's like, what?
I thought you were going to say something quite sweet there.
No.
It's ridiculous.
So there you go, phone
If
in.
I ever ring you with a dead body, would you help me bury it?
Depends whose dead body it was.
Ooh, good answer.
Good answer. Okay, 90242002 is the number. 6300, get your request in.
Hi, here. Actually, when you play Van Morrison, Into the Mystic, please. Thanks. Bye.
We were born before the wind, also younger than the sun. Yeah, the bonnie boat was won as we sailed into the mystic. I can now hear the sailors cry, smell the sea and feel the sky. Let your soul and spirit fly into the mystic. And where that foghorn blows, I will be coming home. Yeah, when the foghorn blows, I wanna hear it. I don't have to fear it, and I wanna rock your gypsy soul. Just like way back in the days of old. Yeah, magnificently we will fold into the mystic. That foghorn blows, you know I will be coming home. And when that foghorn whistle blows, I gotta hear it. I don't have to fear it, and I wanna rock your gypsy soul, just like way back in the day. Together we will fold into the mystic.